Hidey-ho, friendly viewers. This is Hengest. Welcome back to another League of Legends video here in the Summoner's Rift. It's been a long time since we've done a friends and viewers matchup, and that is because, well, I haven't been live streaming as much as I used to, but I did one just the other day for about 4 hours on my personal account, and I had Pure Shield and Keisha join me. AWOL joined us a little bit later. But we were playing some friends and viewers matches. All that entails really is just a custom game where we let the stream know what the game information is and they join. So everyone in here is level 30 and actually around the same skill level, surprisingly enough. That's not very common when we do these. So I picked a game that I thought was really entertaining. One of my best Victor matches, I think. However, not without some fail in it, as usual. But I don't know, I've played Victor once in the TGen squadron, and some people seem to really like that champion. He's pretty uncommon. You don't see him very often, obviously, so why not? Why don't we talk a little bit about Victor, and as well just give the friends and viewers some shout-outs here. Watch him play. I think that makes him feel warm and fuzzy inside, you know, feeling like you're a part of our channel and a part of our community, as you are, literally, given the direction we take with this channel and everything. But anyways, this is a blind pick. That means I don't think there's any mirror matches. I'm just double checking really quickly. Nope, it doesn't look like it. So gonna be a nice heads up match here with a standard meta comp here. Like I said, everybody's around the same skill level, I feel like. Count Catula here, I think he's from Magnus now. I get the teams mixed up. He's an old timer from High Rising, been participating in the first three tournaments. Gonna be playing AD. I think he typically plays top lane. I could be mistaken though. He's going to be playing Varus, and Keisha's down bottom with support Zyra. I'm not a real big fan of support Zyra, just because she's more of a mage, but she does have so much CC, and her mana efficiency is really good as well, that she can do a passable support, although, like I said, I'm not a big fan of it at all. And they're going to be going up against support Lux and ADS. Up top, we have the Chosen Defiant playing Malphite, the Glacial Malphite. It looks giant, huge skin there. Versus Vladimir, I'm going to be laning against a LeBlanc here, Onyu IRL. Pure Shield's going to be jungling Shen. Versus a Darius, Doodle Wank. This guy, he's such a sweetheart. He wanted to play with us so bad. Glad we got him in a match. Anyways, obviously I said I'm laning against LeBlanc. LeBlanc is what I would consider kind of a counter to Victor. Really, she's a counter to most mages in general. Any mage that doesn't have very great range. Victor does have good range with his Death Ray, but anytime you're playing a mage against LeBlanc, it's very scary because she can zone you really hard just because she's pure burst. This champion has like no DPS. She's burst only. She can two-shot most champions in the early levels if you don't have any form of MR. So you can see I'm trying to do my best to farm there with my long-distance Death Ray, but it's going to be really rocky. I haven't had hardly any practice. I think this is the first time I've played against a LeBlanc on Victor, so I'm going to have a really rough time in the beginning matches here. Onyu IRL is also a really great player. He's always out for my blood, it seems like, when we play these matches. You know, if he's not playing somebody like LeBlanc, he's playing Katarina, and he's just trying to kick my ass, always trying to lane against me all the time. So we'll see how this plays out. Looks like Ninja Donut here on Lux, looking to make something happen, possibly a light binding through the wall there. I'm not really sure what this positioning is all about. He's not in range of experience from what I can tell. Maybe a little bit of AFK action. In fact, he's level 1, so he must be AFK. I'm not really sure. Some ping is going down here from Pure Shield. We can't really communicate in real time our plan of action because obviously this is streamed, so I don't accuse people of, well, I guess I jokingly accuse people of stream sniping, but I'm not going to in this video. Although it does happen. I mean, from time to time, people, you know, they're either listening to the stream, they know when we're getting Baron or Dragon, or they're straight up having it open on a dual monitor with like a 6 second delay or something. It does happen, but these are not very hardcore matches at all. In the past, the friends and viewers matches entailed a full-on 5v5 of friends and viewers, and like Pure Shield and myself casting the game in, you know, live spectator. However, since the spectator replay came out, we can play with them and then cast the games afterwards. So I'm going to be doing a solo cast here today, obviously, just because I want to talk a lot about my POV. Look at this, completely unaware of that apprehend gank there from Darius. Nice placement on the gravity field. Is that what it's called? Yeah, gravity field. That's such a powerful ability, so underestimated. I wanted to get kind of ballsy with Darius, kind of wait for Shen to get in position, but he surprised me a little bit there And was that an ignite as well as a hemorrhage? No, just a 5-stack of hemorrhage is going to kill me with the DOT. I didn't realize that at the time, that I was going to go down, so I should have just turned and fought him, but it actually worked out pretty well. A fair exchange there under the tower. Obviously, not very good because that's going to give LeBlanc some free farms. He's going to be able to push my lane a little bit, which is going to make it harder for me to win my lane, although the gold exchange itself was pretty even there. It seems that Ninja Donut is definitely AFK here. I did not realize this at the time, which is unfortunate. But hey, this match really turns out great in the end game, I think. So we're gonna cast the whole thing. And also because, like I mentioned in the past, it is kind of slow in terms of our video output. We are getting some replays from our new circuit. That means teams that have signed up and are participating in our circuit are sending us the replays as they matchmake against each other, which is really great that we're gonna have that content. But for now, you know, these Friends and Viewers matches are really casual. I don't expect people to learn a whole lot watching them, although, hey, you might as well. I don't know, it remains to be seen. But very, very casual. I'm not going to be shoutcasting these, obviously, because I played in them. It's tough for me to feign excitement or anything of the sorts. But there you just saw the full burst combo there from LeBlanc. I could not have escaped there, so I, you know, tried to deal as much damage as I could to her. That was really just a really bad mistake on my part. Overextending, trying to get the farm while getting in her range at this level is very dangerous. The way you have to play against LeBlanc as a mage is like Victor. You gotta play really passively and do get some very early MR so you can take the burst and still farm. I rushed my augment death. It's a very standard strategy on Victor, although it would not have been unwise for me to just straight up get a Negatron cloak and build that into an Abyssal Scepter right away before even getting my augment death. Obviously, I just need to focus on farm at this point in the match. And I am obviously a much better late-game champion than LeBlanc, although she has been getting better. Pretty sure getting pretty harassed there by Darius. Gotta be careful he doesn't get... Actually, he can't get ulted. He's still only level 5. Probably would have died if Darius was level 6, actually. But here, I learned my lesson, I think. I've died twice now. And at this point on the stream, I'm kind of just raging a little bit. You know how I get. Get very upset. The first one was, yeah, okay, I died to Darius, it was a fair trade. The second one, just totally getting smashed by LeBlanc's burst. Here we see Darius is going to hand off the blue to LeBlanc. It looks like everybody else is doing pretty standard. Ninja Donut, I think, is... I don't really know what his situation is. Maybe they're trying to feed as much EXP to Ez as possible. I have no idea what's going on with that. Pure wants to hand off the blue to me, which is good, because I just got level 6. I can start harassing, and if I can get in enough harass, you can really surprise people with the Chaos Storm burst damage. Taking a look at farm, up top we have the Chosen Defiant playing Wallflight. He has 34 farm versus Vladimir's 42, so he's a little bit behind. That's to be expected given that Vladimir obviously one of the ultimate sustained champions and he's ranged, so early game farm going to be in his favor. I do want to quickly give the Chosen Defiant a shout out. He played really well when we were doing the stream, played like 3 matches. And I top laned against him one time. I don't remember if he was lagging or what, but he got smashed pretty hard against my Nidalee top lane. So I jokingly said, "Oh, you're no longer the Chosen Defiant. You're just the Defiant." And he, you know, he's like, "Okay." And then he's been trying to redeem himself ever since. And after today, or after this day, definitely redeems himself as being the Chosen Defiant. Nice gamer sense here from Pure Shield, paying the Darius, anticipating that red steel. And response time for me, obviously, pretty timely. He had to choose the lesser of two evils there. Decided to go into the pot lane, probably trying to avoid feeding me. Not really sure what his thought process was there. A better chance of survival if he ran through the mid lane, but yeah, not very good for the Darius there. Really unfortunate. But most importantly, that was a good call by Pure Shield. I did end up getting that kill, though, doing a little bit of scouting. I'm a bit paranoid here of LeBlanc in the bush, as she has had quite a lead on me. She's level 8 right now with a lot more farm. She's 50 farm versus my 37. However, this dragon kill is really going to close the gap. Actually, we were a little bit ahead in terms of overall farm, but that's going to give us the lead right now. The only lane we're actually losing is mid lane, because there's been no top kill exchange up top. The farm difference is negligible. And at this point, again, anticipating LeBlanc's burst. And here, this time I'm calling for Pure Shield. That burst that she had on me was actually straight through United We Stand. She burned straight through the shield and was able to take half of my HP. So this is a point where LeBlanc is still extremely scary. She can roam around and dominate people, but she starts to fall off very soon. I'd say about the 15-minute mark, if your team can pick up some MR, then she becomes a really, how do I say this? She's not a very good team champion. She serves only as an assassin, which is okay. I mean, it's good if for taking out enemy mages or the AD carry, more importantly. But towards the later games of the match, if you don't have a whole lot of utility, you're not going to be helping your team very much, and it's going to give you a disadvantage in those 5v5s. For example, Victor has a lot of AoE. His death ray and the Chaos Storm is very AoE intensive. Look at this. I was screaming in the stream because I wanted his Darius to die from the minion balls so badly, but he survived because of the potion. Downstairs, we just saw an exchange between the two ADs. How are they doing on farm? 79 versus 61. Our team slightly ahead. But anyway, as I was saying, towards the late game, you take somebody like Victor, for example. He's a mage, he deals a ton of damage. He has an AoE stun, and he has a lot of AoE damage. And he can also shield himself, so a lot more utility than a champion like LeBlanc. However, LeBlanc's single point burst is far superior, especially at this point in the match. So if you're going to pick LeBlanc like ONU IRL decided to do here, there's nothing wrong with that at all. It's just your emphasis is more on the early to mid game and getting a really heavy lead at that point in the match so that you can become more effective in the late game, given that your abilities are more solo or laning oriented than most other champions, if that makes sense. So most of you intermediate players already know that, obviously, but I do try to keep my videos pretty beginner friendly for people that are just picking up League of Legends, etc. Here I don't have enough ability power to one-shot minions because I'm behind. Typically, if you have the augment death, you can one-shot minions an entire wave just with the DOT. The caster minions tend to get one-shot, so I only have a blasting wand at this point. Normally I would have a needlessly large rod, but I've been shut down and zoned a little bit, so I'm behind on gold for sure. We just saw a kill exchange downstairs. Ezreal went down again. That's gonna put Varus even further ahead of the AD down here, and obviously Ninja Donut is way behind on EXP. Not really sure, probably because he was AFK, but he's caught up just fine. Overall bot lane, Darius really needs to do something about this, because Varus is actually very scary when he gets fed, just because of his missile that deals a tremendous amount of AoE damage in a team fight. He's actually far more useful as a sniper than a lot of other AD carries. An underestimated champion for the most part, in my opinion. Look at the true damage from Zyra's passive on Ezreal just as he got back, chunking off a quarter of his HP. He's got to be pretty upset about that one. Here I go again, trying to get in range of some more CS, and look at how badly that cost me. Look at how much that cost me. Almost my entire HP. Still don't have any MR. I decide she's going to catch me, so I got to make a change here. I got to turn around and try to kill her. That was not an even exchange for ONU IRL, because I was worth less gold than him, although he obviously did not think I would be able to kill him. A lot of people underestimate the initial damage from the Chaos Storm, which is, it's very similar to a Tibbers. If I had to compare it to one ability, it'd be Tibbers. This is Victor's ultimate I'm talking about. And that it does a ton of initial damage in AoE, and then it chases people around with a DOT, a percentage-based dot. And I also hit him with that true damage from the ignites. There was no way he was going to survive that. His miscalculation was in the initial hit from the Chaos Storm, which is really just, it happens because people don't play against Victor enough. He's not picked enough. So that actually is very advantageous if you're a good Victor player to pick him up and you know, play him frequently, because a lot of people are unfamiliar with the champion, which works out amazingly in your favor, obviously. But anyways, I'm catching up a little bit slowly. What did I just pick up when I died? Finished out my Sorcerer's Shoes, I believe. Trying to get up a little bit of extra movement speed. This is a mistake on my part. Obviously, I was going to be behind, but it was just foolish of me to not get an Abyssal Scepter earlier. I went pretty standard with a Doran's Ring and then a Blasting Wand, and even finished off my Magic Pen Boots, which there's a United We Stand again, cushioning a lot of the LeBlanc Burst. But it would have been very wise at this point for me to just get a Negatron's Cloak and just focus on farm. Here we're going to see a bit of a 4v3 from the looks of things. Actually, Vlad is further behind. It's more of a 3v3. And yeah, we're going to get owned in this exchange. That was not good. LeBlanc getting even more fed as we get to the 15-minute mark. This is right about the time she starts to fall off. However, if she can continue to get fed and get kills, then she can maintain her dominance for a little bit while longer. Here we see Vladimir going in for a gank on me from downstairs, getting up my my power transfer shield right before he lifesteals me. Negligible damage there coming from Giru. Giru's the guy that placed Pantheon against Pierce Shield up top, and tends to beat him in lane, which is pretty funny. I think he's actually a quite high-rated player, if I'm not mistaken. Well, you can see I'm catching up on farm quite a bit. 85 CS now versus LeBlanc's 74. Let's check out our global gold at the mid lane. I have 4,600. She has 4,400. So my farm actually making up for the difference. Even though she's landed all those kills, I'm still ahead in terms of my overall gold, as you can tell by our items. The augment death obviously costs 1,000 gold, for those of you unfamiliar. Any augment costs 1,000 gold. And that's essential for Victor, by the way. Anyways, I'm pretty much caught up at this point, but I just almost lost my life again. Look at this Ezreal. I was flipping out when I saw that coming. I almost ran right into it just because I panicked. Man, what a bad play. On my part, that is. I could have just gone back easily. But anyways, I did manage to close the gap, and now I'm finally going to, you know, develop my brainstem a little bit and decide, yeah, I need to get an Abyssal Scepter because I almost just gave up another kill to LeBlanc. She's not falling off as quickly as I hoped she would. So there we go. I just picked up my Negatron, and I'm going to use that to build an Abyssal Scepter as soon as possible. Normally at this point in the match, I'd be looking to get my death cap around the 40 or around the 20-minute mark, which is great against most mid lanes, but against LeBlanc, it's just not an option. We go Pierce Shield running in blindly in that bush, getting exhausted, dashing over the wall. Strong play on his part, but he should not have run in there at all. Keisha kind of just had to self-sacrifice there, and it does appear that he's going to get three-manned to death there. Feeding up Vlad a little bit, that's kind of scary. Vlad is an amazing mid to late game champion as well. A lot of people would argue with me on that point, but I think he's amazing towards the end game, actually. Here I spotted this Darius with a ward at Dragon. And he wisely flashes out, but I'm going to counter-flash him. Chase him down, use my Chaos Storm there. Simply because it's a reasonably low cooldown when I have blue buff up. About 90 seconds. In fact, exactly 90 seconds with the blue buff. And I just needed that kill. I needed the extra gold because I want to get my Abyssal as soon as possible and start carrying this match. Because if you haven't noticed, our damage is pretty low. Pierce Shield's a support jungle. Malphite kind of a tanky top laner. All we really have is myself and Varus. Varus has been getting kills and farming quite well, so not really too concerned about him. He's got 121 CS versus Ezreal's 87, so he's way behind downstairs. However, I am live streaming after all, so it'd be kind of a shame if I wasn't carrying the match, you know, just for showboating. This is going to be our second dragon now. Take a look at the global gold counters. We're only 2,000 gold apart with the same amount of team kills, 12 and 12. There you can see I absorbed LeBlanc's damage a lot better with the Negatrons. It makes so much difference. There's Smite secure. So much difference to have that 48 MR against a champion like LeBlanc who deals entirely magic damage. There's just no reason not to get a Negatron if you're laning against LeBlanc. That's something I kind of just decided after this match, is that you just have to. There we go. Varus actually grabbing that kill on Darius. I almost grabbed that one. Look at Ezreal trying to snipe us through the blue nest there. And Vlad looks like he's going to lose his life. Will a blood pool save him? Yeah, he's going to have no problem with that summoner heal. Actually, unnecessarily using the summoner heal. Overall, an exchange in our favor. As we were able to take down LeBlanc and Darius, and they only got our Shen. And Shen's actually not worth that much gold right now, because I think he's given up 3 kills in a row. Could be mistaken. Haven't been paying too much attention. Trying to tunnel vision on myself here. Look at Ezreal. Why is he shifting out of the gravity field, but again, turning around to fight me, not anticipating the initial damage from Chaos Storm? If you don't have magic resist, I mean, Victor, I would compare it to a Tibbers, equivalent to a Tibbers. Deals 250 base damage with a 1-to-1 ratio, I believe. What is my AP yet? I'm not really sure exactly what the ratio is, but it's a ton of damage initially. And as it turns, it deals DOT over time, scales extremely well with ability power. One of the strongest team fighting ultimates in the game, in my opinion. Obviously, it doesn't stun like Tibbers, but it does chase way faster than the average champion and deals a lot of damage in AoE. So it's hard for me to say it's better than Tibbers. It's definitely safer than Tibbers. You don't have to be as close, and you don't have to micro the Tibbers or be in range of enemy champions to get the DOT. Obviously, Tibbers has kind of that whole Sunfire thing going on, and it's just not as effective as an independent unit that can't take damage and chases champions. So I love Victor, and Like I said, a lot of people don't understand how he works, and that's really working out in my favor, as Ezreal and LeBlanc have been surprised by the Chaos Storm so far. Here I'm going to try to farm up the blue, but I'm in actually a lot of danger. I didn't realize both these players were here right now, and deciding not to try to steal that one, as it was a 3v2 situation. Wise choice on their part. I'm getting pretty frightened of Darius, although he has been killed 6 times. He's just a really scary champion towards this point in the match. If he can position himself well, then he can dominate so hard. The problem though with the red team's comp is that they don't have a true tank. A lot of people make the mistake of thinking that Darius is a bruiser or a straight tank, and he's far from it. He's closest to an assassin than anything else. Oh, that light binding saved 2 of their players right there. I was going to cleave the hell out of them, but cleaving some here because they got way too aggressive. Picking up a double kill for myself, getting monstrously fed at this point. And here I'm just daring Ezreal to come in after me. Power here. I'm just like, yeah, come on, shift over the wall. I want you to, I dare you. But yeah, I'm pretty fed at this point. As I was saying about the red team comp though, they don't have a true tank. Darius can only be super effective with his ult and his, you know, his pentakilling stuff if somebody initiates for him, and they don't really have someone to do that. You know, he's their tankiest champion. Vladimir would have to build straight, you know, mage tank if he wanted to initiate, which he can do, and possibly a fault on the part of Giru that he wasn't building more tanky for his team. But yeah, that's really going to cost them, because that pretty much takes Darius's damage out of the picture. If he's forced into an initiation role, he's not going to be able to land the kills necessary for him to be super effective. So overall, the red team's comp is not good. In fact, I remember them saying that they were going to lost the game, or they were going to lose at champion select, which is pretty funny to think about. That does happen in the pro level matches, but at this level of play, anything can happen. You know, team comp is not everything. But certainly after the 20-minute mark, when LeBlanc starts to fall off, it does start to play a huge role. Victor, one of the better late-game mages, in my opinion. So we're going to focus a little bit on me, because this is my time to shine. I have my Abyssal Scepter up now. I want to get my Death Cap as soon as possible. How much gold do I have in the bank? Yeah, I definitely have enough for a Needlessly Rod Gerard. I'm just waiting to pick up a kill before I go back again. But at this point, I can take LeBlanc in a 1v1, no problem. Just because I have the MR necessary to deal with her. What is she building? Just take a closer look. Yeah, she's building straight AP. So if you math it out, I have a far better exchange ratios against her in a 1v1 situation. She's really the only person I was worried about. They did manage to pick off Zyra there. Kind of a overzealous bait there. And I wanted to chase down LeBlanc so bad. Pure Shield wasting his ultimate one to get the assist on Varus for the LeBlanc kill. And I decided not to pursue her, I imagine. Yeah, she just gets away. Unfortunate. But there are more impending matters here, as we do have a 5v4, or 4v4, excuse me, situation baking here. I'm trying to hit the Vlad and the farm at the same time. Really should just focus on the Vlad. But the farm always good, even during these teamfight situations when you have that blue buff up and the additional CDR. So I'm going to go around and try to flank here. I actually was calling for Pure Shield to initiate right here, because I do have my Chaos Storm up. There we go, with a wall fight initiation. Completely melting Vladimir. Vart's going to pick up the kill on Darius there, as I dealt the majority of the damage. Look at this. Ninja Donut has no MR. Just, oh man, power transferring so much of his HP down right there. He has got to get some MR if he wants to survive in this match. Here we go, LeBlanc laying a nice kill. Is it going to cost him? No, they're going to be able to push back Pure Shield again. What was I doing there in that exchange? I should have actually been fighting there. Almost getting that Pure Shield kill with Diaz ultimate there. Actually, he doesn't have enough AD. True Shot Barrage really doesn't scale well with AD at all. It doesn't deal that much damage at a single target if you're building straight AD. So Pure Shield would have actually survived that one. But here we go. It's a little bit of friendly banter here in the chat. I was arguing with Pure Shield about how much damage Darius can deal if built properly at this point in the match. He's like, no, don't worry about it. It's like, oh yeah, level 3 Noxian Guillotine only deals like 702 damage, you know? No big deal. Which is really, I mean, Darius is an excellent anti-tank, which is what Pure Shield is playing. Shen, obviously. Some people build Last Whisper on Darius. You don't really need to, actually, because he deals so much true damage. You can just cleave, you know, just slice right through the armor and, yeah, just the armor and the health, really. At this point, though, let's take a look at Victor. 8-4-4. Those 4 kills, I gave up early. I'd say two of them were big mistakes on my part. The other two were really just because I was laning against LeBlanc and got unlucky with a gank. You know, not too many kills, although could have played a lot better in the early game. However, those of you that watch me play a lot, you'll probably notice that my forte is actually in team fighting. Late game carry. You know, when I play AD, I always shine in the late game. It's just more my playstyle. Not to say I can't lane, but I definitely enjoy team fighting more than anything else in League of Legends. So this is when I start to really dominate people. Look at that. No MR on the Lux. The power transfer just shredding straight through her health. And he was pretty far behind from the beginning. Anyways, but yeah, that was pretty remarkable. Here we go. Thought I'm using his ultimate. Tempted to Chaos Storm right there, but just going to pick up the kill with the Death Ray. Actually, Chosen's going to grab up that last hit. And here we go. Darius getting way too ballsy. There's the Chaos Storm murdering those two players right there. So much damage. Not even microing it after the LB. Flashing over the wall and trying to Death Ray her in the enemy base, but I'm pretty low on mana, and that's a pretty risky exchange, as it did cost Chosen Defiant his life. Although, pretty good exchange, actually, because she was worth more gold than him, and I got the assist for the LeBlanc kill. So, big play there by Chosen Defiant, acing the team. Gonna allow us to CJ up here a little bit. We don't have the damage or the mana to take down Baron, obviously. The two of us, that is, as Zyra does not have any heals. So, I'm just gonna grab up this blue buff and do a little bit of counter juggling there. I should have actually grabbed enemy blue in hindsight. I didn't know it was up, even though we have this ward here. Pretty bad mistake on my part, actually. But yep, I'm going to grab up this blue buff and then go straight back to the Nexus to finish off. Oh, what am I going to get now? I think I got a Zhonya's. Zhonya's is a great defensive item, as you guys well know, but it's also one of the all-time best AP scaling items in terms of offense. Because of that needlessly large rod, it's just raw ability power that scales so well with a Rabdon. So if you want to go balls in offense, then you gotta get a Zhonya's. Because it complements so well with the percentage-based AP scaling from the death cap. So I actually didn't have enough for the Zhonya's, just picked up my rod instead. Here I am, a very scary force to be reckoned with now. 175 farm, you can see I left LeBlanc in the dust. Farming with Victor, once you have a certain amount of AP, is so easy with the death ray. You just one-shot every minion wave. It's so easy to farm. Which is another reason I love this champion so much. Pure Shield looking like he wants a solo dragon over here. We're going to be able to pick this one up. Are we going to see any sort of a contest here from the red team? It doesn't appear so. In fact, they're not even aware of this because of no ward placement. Overall, the blue team, our team, is playing exceptionally well. Look at LeBlanc. She's going to try to steal this one almost. If she had Smite, she would have had it no problem. But very nice play there from ONU IRL. Just missing the Baron steal by a hair. Props to Pierce Shield's Smite Reflex. Actually, he didn't even use Smite. That's just overall damage. A little bit of a waste on that Ez ult there. When you're AD, it doesn't deal that much damage, as I've been saying. So you really want to use it to pick up kills or assassinating certain targets. Look at that. Just using my Chaos Storm to melt Lux. A little bit of a waste. In fact, a lot of waste, given that she wasn't worth that much. I just wanted to prove how much damage it does to these guys because they were doubting the Victor play. And yeah, with no MR on Lux, it was devastating. Down goes Darius to a combination of DOTs and a hit there from Varus. And here we're just murdering their team. Death Ray cleaving up, actually grabbing the kill over the wall. Just grabbing all these assists with the Death Ray. It's such a powerful ability. I say it's the strongest in the game. I say a lot of abilities are like that. I'm just a fanboy of champions at certain times. LeBlanc's going to be able to burst down Pure Shield there. And Chosen's actually going to flash after that kill and grab it, no problem. Here I'm like, no, you got to take the tower for me. No, no. And then I'm like, oh, survive. Oh, wait. Shit. I forgot this tower was up. And give up and execute there. So my fifth death. But that one didn't give gold to anybody. And obviously I'm still on my killing spree, so I'm still worth 600 gold, which is unfortunate. But anyways, this game isn't over, although we do have a tremendous lead at this point. And really, it's going to be extremely difficult for the red team to come back. Not because they're unskilled or because they're too far behind, but because of their team comp. It's just a really bad team comp. You know, this is a blind pick. These guys don't actually know each other. So, for all intents and purposes, you can pretty much compare it to a normal pick. Normal queue. However, you know, they do have a chance to communicate with each other on a more personal level. and they just decided to not have a straight tank, and that's really what's costing them right now. We have two tanks. We have Shen and Malphite, who are doing an exceptional job of guarding our Varus and our Victor, which is just so dominant. Here we see Kaisha, wow, getting completely evaporated right there. Like I said, not a big fan of the Zyra support. She does have a Will of the Ancients, though, so that's really helpful for me, at least. Although, apart from that and placing wards, she doesn't really provide a whole lot of utility. In a teamfight situation, her ult can be very powerful. It can mix up the positioning, and her roots, if landed, can kind of serve as a light binding or a dark binding, similar ability. It deals comparable damage as well. But she's just not as tanky as, you know, Morgana. She doesn't have a shield like Lux. She's just not a very good support, in my opinion. However, she can, you know, play support, obviously, I've been saying. We are doing the unwise thing and trying to push down the base, the Nexus, right now. When we have two lanes pushed, we could easily, you know, push those lanes individually, even split push. I'm like, why are we doing this? It's like, yeah, whatever, we got two tanks here guarding me, I'm not really concerned. Let's just melt some people. They don't have a whole lot of MR at all. Look at their team. Only Vlad and LeBlanc have wised up to get some Negatrons. But look, Darius, no MR. Lux, no MR. Ezreal, no MR. That is like Victor heaven right now, especially with these two amazing tanks. I'm just able to dominate this match, and that's exactly what's about to happen. So here we go. LeBlanc's trying to close in on me, assassinate, but nice reflexes there on gravity field, completely closing off her advance. You'd be a fool to walk through the gravity field against a fed Victor, just asking to get destroyed. Taking a little bit of harass damage here, a little bit of poke. Malphite and Shen obviously can sustain that with the life regen, but you know, the carries that don't have lifesteal really should not be getting poked at all. It's just not smart. Here again, closing off LeBlanc's advance yet again, wasting the Chaos Storm to kill the Darius. Really just getting super excited. I'm full on HP. I'm not really concerned. Look at this. The death ray barely picks him. Flash with the power transfer and ignite to kill Vlad in the blood pool. Long range death ray on LeBlanc after the initiate there from Malphite. It's a really strong play here, actually. Great synergy between the friends and viewers and, you know, members of the squadron. We don't, you know, I don't play together with these guys at all, hardly. And it seems like this is some pretty damn good team play in hindsight. So, I wouldn't say the teams are imbalanced. It's just, again, the team comp really did the red team in here. And possibly just a slight imbalance in terms of team coordination. Overall, though, this is not going to be the Nexus push, I don't believe, as Lux managed to snipe down Varus. That's half of our damage now gone. Missing the death ray on Ez, which is unfortunate because I probably could have evaporated him there. But look at this. Zyra's ultimate is going to save my life there with a knockup. Spoke too soon about her being a crappy support. Power transfer on the shield kept me alive for Darius' DOTs, and Darius is going to chase this one down. He does have the movement speed buff, actually, just subsided. He gets it whenever he has a bleed on somebody, but he's getting slowed a lot, and I'm just having enough mana there restored to turn around and power transfer him for the kill. I was that entire chasing. I was like, no, just keep running, I can't save you. And then finally enough mana came up for the power transfer, and you saw how much damage dealt against Varus, or excuse me, against Darius, who has no MR. So a lot of people, I don't know, they like to analyze the damage output of mages, and I have to say Victor's damage output is not nearly as bursty as a lot of other champions. LeBlanc probably one of the biggest differences, you know, biggest contrast. And he's a great example of a bursty mage, as well as, you know, a lot of other champions I like to play. But Victor is not bursty. He's actually more sustained. He has the DOT from the Augment Death, from the Chaos Storm. And overall, he's very dependent on kiting with the power, or with the gravity field and the range from the death ray. So overall, not one of the bursty's champions, but overall damage has got to be damn well near the top. I'd put him in top 3 damage output overall for mages, AP champions. He's just that good. Super underrated champion. And I imagine if we keep posting videos like this, you know, with Uranium on Reboot and myself, you know, just Victor play videos showing how dominant he can be, I imagine a lot more people will start to play him. I mean, I'm not going to toot my own horn and say, oh, when I started posting APS videos, it became a lot more popular. I'm not going to take credit for that, even though I'd like to. But, yeah, I mean, awareness about the power and the usability of certain champions really is undisclosed. And when you make videos about it, Here I was spamming my Zhonya's. I'm like, why isn't this working? I didn't realize that you couldn't Zhonya's while in a silence. Huge noob mistake on my part. Also really bad positioning. Got sandwiched in between a minion wave. It was fucking up my padding. Really sloppy play. Just fed up 600 gold. Idiot Hengist. Anyway, as I was saying, a lot of people, they don't have the confidence or even the interest to try on, you know, underplayed champions without seeing it played to the max yet. I'm not saying I can play Victor to the max, but certainly it is motivating to see videos where it does happen from time to time. I say that as I just fed 600 gold to LeBlanc and a huge assist to Ezreal. You know how it is. Lux is laser, level 3. She does have some CDR. I think she built a Morelos, didn't she? Yeah, she built a Morelos and a DFG. Not very support friendly there. But the Morelos actually, I think, is 20% CDR. Yeah. 20% CDR. So she's spamming those lasers. It's 24 second cooldown. God, that's ridiculous. Morelos Lux, 24 second cooldown on the CDR. It's crazy. And if you're playing Mage Lux, you know, mid lane Lux, and you go with that build, you can snipe so many kills at this point in the match. That's why so many people build Mage Eyes on Lux. It's because even if you don't get the kills, you still get the assists. And if you play passively, you don't die. So Lux, super underestimated as well. I need to play more Lux with those rapid fire lasers. 24 second laser, man. That's crazy. Although this does appear this is going to be the final push here from the blue team. I'm just like, yeah, I'm going to farm top while you guys handle the rest. As I am now maxed out, I don't have elixirs because I didn't have the gold at the time, just 400 gold on me right now. The only thing left for me to do would be to get blue buff and some elixirs and then go for the final push, but obviously that's not necessary because we're so far ahead at this point. The only way I'm really going to die is if I go 2v1 alone, like an idiot, as I just did a little while ago. Piercio's getting a little bit trolly here. He's like, yeah, I'm just going to tank this tower, 7 hits, and then get ulted by Darius. And that just goes to show, man, Darius will murder a tank with his ultimate at this point in the match. He just needs a true damage. That's all it takes. He's actually great against somebody like Malphite as well. Ooh, look at that. Chaos Storm combined with the Malphite ulti. Huge plays from the Chosen Defiant to myself. That was really fun. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Not really casting this match for educational purposes or even because it was amazing. Just because I love to give recognition to the friends and viewers. So thank you guys for playing with me in the live stream. You make it so fun, and it's always a pleasure, guys. If you guys want to play with us live, then just follow my stream or the TGen stream. I'll have some links in the description below. We'll get around to doing this more often. But yeah, good games, friends and viewers, and we'll see you next time. Have a good one. Bye-bye.